With time, if I keep at it, I will definitely be converting that talent to something that will be much more useful to the society.
So did you get any encouragement from that tender age?
Yes, not encouragement to do music at this scale, but even when I got the hint that I could actually do music, I knew, of course, in this part of the world, doing music is expensive. Okay, from production to promotion and so on and so forth. So I said to myself that, look, the first thing is to finish my education, get a job, okay, build up
your
resources,
career, yeah.
Okay, that will enable me to go into music. You know, because if you walk up to people of goodwill and tell them, look, I have this passion for music, they may want to ask you, okay, so what do you have? Right, to put down for the project, and you say nothing, it's often very difficult. But if you're able to at least push yourself to a certain significant level, right, it becomes easier for people to come and give you help.
A lot of people just think that because you can rap, because you can put one or two words together to form a rhythm and all of that, you know, you are a musician. So let us know what it takes to be a good musician.
Well, you know, just like in production, it's never complete until whatever is being produced gets to the final user. So also is entertainment. So for you to be a good musician, first, your songs must have the right content. It's not just about the melody. Melody entertains, but what keeps the song alive in people's mind are those encouraging words, those contents that inspires. Okay, so once that is done, then you begin to talk about promotion. You have to make the song, you know, visible. You have to make it accessible to people. Like in those days, it was a lot easier. You have just NTA and few stations, okay? Less emphasis on internet, which means once NTA takes your song, you are sure that the entire country has seen it. But today, to be a good musician, you must be present online. You must
streaming platforms.
Yes, most of the streaming platform. You must identify with NTA, just like other people, and a lot of other platforms. So the implication is that it takes a lot of energy. It takes a lot of energy and determination, and it's very discouraging. But if you are not determined, that frustration will get at you and you just drop off.
You talked about discouraging in terms of lack of finance to push your music.
Yes, it's part of it. Finance to push your music, and secondly, you know, though we rise by raising others, but you find that in this part of the world, people are not too eager to raise the other person, believing that whatever effort they put into doing so may just see you overtaking them, if you don't mind.
Yeah, but they fail to realize that overtaking is allowed.
So you then find out that as a young person coming into this space, there will be a lot of things that will really discourage you. But the focus for us in gospel space, I do not seek validation from anybody. I know I'm singing for God. It's gospel music, the messages and teachings of Christ. So I don't own those messages. The lyrics in my songs don't belong to me. Okay, these are things in the scripture. So I can't put it out there and begin to expect people to start worshiping me because I'm reinforcing what they already know. So I don't seek validation. That's for gospel space. I don't know, maybe secular, something of that could happen. But so those are some of the issues. If you are doing music and you are in this space that I am, and you're seeking validation, you might be heartbroken.
Okay.
Okay, so yeah, Mighty God was done to inspire hope, you know, in people that no matter your situation, we serve a God that cannot fail us. You see, the devil has this beautiful line that he will always draw, you know, telling you that, look at, you can't be serving God and be going through these difficulties. You can't be serving God and not have this and not have that. So, naturally, you expect those with little faith to just conclude that, well, God is not on my side. And you see, crime and criminality is has direct correlation with your level of hopelessness. If you feel that this thing is not going to happen again, it's not happening for me again. So, I mean, what is life all about? You just give up and continue to do terrible things. So, with Mighty God, I try to make it danceable. So that in the breath of dancing, you are still getting the message. I'm trying to tell you that I serve a mighty God that cannot fail me.
Yeah, indeed. Indeed, yeah, God cannot fail.
Yes.
So you rightly said that the lyrics of the songs are yours, they're from the scriptures. Okay, good. Now, let's talk about your other songs. I have seen You Alone
Can Heal.
Yes. Yeah. So, how often do you release new songs?
Okay, my songs are released based on how I feel the pulse of my immediate environment. Because what I do, or my thought process in writing songs is I look at my immediate environment, I see what people are struggling with, you know, so I research the Bible, because no matter the situation you're going through, we have record of someone that has gone through those situations in the Bible, so I research, then also get a solution. So I'm talking to you about what you know, but I'm just putting it in music. For example, You Alone Can Heal is just like a song that supports healing process, right? It's affirming God's ultimate healing power. You see, you alone can change my life. There are other lines that really touch you and make you begin to think about God. Jesus never failed. It's one of my favorite tracks because there I was telling my own story. You know, for someone who never thought he would see the four walls of a school, not for want of intellectualism, but I mean, if nobody is there to support you, okay, I was brought up by a widow. I saw her struggles. So I just knew that it wasn't meant to be. But it happened for me. It happened for me how God saw me to the second degree. I cannot tell. It's God factor. So that Jesus never fails. There I was talking about trying to let people understand. And the same way God turned water to wine,
turned
the situation around.
That's a good message for Nigerians, for those who have lost hope, you know, that things will not get better, that your life will not get better. This is just a message, an advice, you know, for you to hold on to, that do not give up. When there is life, actually, there is hope. Okay, and God will never fail.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yeah, very correct.
Okay, yeah. So, your other tracks now?
Okay, so I have My Praise.
Okay.
That's another danceable song. My Praise was done to inspire the culture of gratitude. You know, we often attribute our successes, our achievements in life, to how intelligent we are, how connected, power, so on and so forth.
Not knowing that it's the man up there that's made all those things possible.
Whoever God is using to help me is doing so because God has touched him to do so. So that we don't continue to take the glory of God or put ourselves in the place of God. So no matter what I've achieved in life, no matter what I'm still going to achieve in life, let God and God alone take all the praises. Acknowledge people that God is using around you. But please, give the praise to God.
Okay. Now, let's look at music and nation building.
Yeah.
Are you of the opinion that music helps in developing a nation.
Yes, yes, and very strongly so, because what you listen to every time has a way of, you know, influencing how you behave.
Mm-hmm.
So music, like we saw at the beginning of the program, is a language that cut across. It's a language that everybody understands. So government should begin to pay attention on that aspect of our life. If you are in gym, you're listening to music. In the kitchen, you're listening to music. Driving, you're listening to music. So we should ensure that the right contents encourage the musicians to put out the right contents,
mm-hmm.
nothing negative.
Yes.
Right contents. So when people are reinforced with those positive thinking, it will affect the way they will also be. So music is a catalyst to nation building.
All right, so like they say, from the abundance of the heart,
yeah.
the mouth speaks.
Exactly.
And just as the Holy Book talks about the tongue, that is a powerful weapon. So it's what you say
yeah.
that will
it's happen. Exactly.
Okay, exactly. All right, so let's take another of Austin Adigwe's song, and we'll come back to talk about him as a person. Austin Adigwe in the house, and right now we'll be talking about Austin Adigwe as a person. And it's good to know that he's from Delta State.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic.
Yes, yes. You know the Robo man will say Robo Bobo. We are one. Proudly Delta.
Delta
is Obuluku in Delta State.
Yes.
All right. You said you were raised by a widow, mm-hmm. and you saw the struggles, yes. you know. So you decided that you must make it right in life.
Yes.
So tell us more about you.
Okay, so Austin Adigwe is a child of destiny, like I said. My father left us long ago. He passed on when I think I was about 2 years
oh.
plus. So, and from there it became a very big struggle. My mom, a teacher, you know, had to manage resources to take care of the 4 of us.
Mm.
After the other siblings. So we went through the system. We left the comfort of where we were in Warri back to the village. We had to relocate to, you know, kind of stabilize again. So, but in all the struggles, I later understood that challenges are not supposed to break us.
Mm, to make us strong.
To make us very strong. See, in every crisis, there is a crown.
Mm.
If you focus too much on the crisis,
you lose the crown.
So all that period, I just kept telling her that, Mom, I will make you proud. I didn't really know how it was.
I hope mom is...
She's late
now. Oh.
She passed on in 2011. She's
late.
So I just kept telling myself that I will make this woman proud. Because there was a question I asked. I said, you don't have good clothes, but you get your salary, you buy me clothes, you buy my... Why can't you buy your own? And she says, don't worry. You will understand much later. You know, so it was a struggle. Went through secondary school. I went to LASU.
Mm-hmm.
I did my first degree in LASU. Before then, I had gone to Lagos Poly. So
okay.
I've really moved right.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I did the business administration in Lagos Poly. Then went to LASU. My love for economics actually was what took me to the university. So I did my first degree in LASU. Now I did my second degree in economics in University of Lagos.
Okay.
So I'm back to LASU now for my PhD.
Mm.
So I'm just like asking myself, why is that possible? Why is God doing this?
Okay. It's good you're trying to reach out to a larger world through your music. Now, we want you to put out a word to upcoming, you know, artists, those who want to become musicians. Some will just say they don't need to go to school since they can just compose, they are talented, they can play some instruments, they just go to the studio and knock one song out of it. So I want you to talk to us and let them also know the importance of getting an education first before, you know, going into music, or do it pari passu.
Yes, okay, so my advice to my brothers and sisters that want to have a career in music. For any endeavor in life, you need a certain level of education to be more effective. You know, so it's important that nothing takes you away from that.
Mm.
You must have it as something that is sacrosanct in your life. You must be educated, because you cannot give what you don't have.
Exactly.
So it is only through education that you'll be able to communicate even more effectively.
Mm-hmm.
It is only through education that you know that some of the things we think are important are actually not important. Like, you know, like I said earlier, if you go out, you are struggling with a particular aspect of life. Okay, you might be struggling because you are seeking validation. But if you are well educated, you understand that yours is to give this service. Yours is to put out this content. And it is God that blesses. So when it is time for your own blessing, nobody will stop it.
Mm-hmm.
But if you are seeking validation from men, you won't go far.
That is the truth. Because the day you do not heed the call of that particular person.
Yes. Honestly.
Okay, now finally, we always try to, you know, chip in our own words to encourage Nigerians to be conscious of their health. COVID-19 is still around. We have moved from the main COVID-19 to the Delta COVID-19. Omicron. And now we now have the Omicron COVID-19. So just help me chip in one or two words. I suppose you've taken your vaccine.
Sure, fully vaccinated. Okay, so COVID-19 is real, and vaccination only improves your chances of fighting off this deadly and global disease. Take your vaccine, observe all the advice of the health professionals for you to stay alive. COVID-19 is real.
Thank you very much, Austin Adigwe. It's been nice having you on Saturday night.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
So until I come away again with another guest on the same platform, I am Adeola Komi Akere saying, God bless you. God bless Nigeria. Bye-bye.